To get started with AR mode, you will need to create an anchor. An anchor locks your reference image in place, so you can move your phone or your canvas. And as long as the anchor is in the camera's view, your reference image will align itself back perfectly with what you are drawing. To get started, take a business card sized piece of paper or larger. Then take a black marker and do your best Jackson Pollock impression. Make a lot of squiggles with many intersecting points and different shapes. The more tiny little details, the better. The larger you make your anchor, the further away from your canvas you can have the phone and still have accurate placement. It's a good idea to tape your anchor in place on your paper before you draw. This ensures that your reference image will always be in the right place. You should be prompted to make an anchor right away. However, if you want to make a new anchor, press Tools, then AR, then Anchors. To upload your anchor, press Add Anchor in the top right corner of the screen. Press the purple button at the bottom of the screen to bring up the camera. Make sure your camera is perfectly level with the anchor. You don't want to have it tilted like this or like this, or else it could distort your overlay image when it is projected onto your paper. When you're finished taking a picture, press the OK button at the bottom right corner of the screen. Next, you need to crop your anchor. Drag the corners of the cropping frame to the edges of your anchor. Make sure there is no background visible. Then, press Crop at the top right corner of the screen. The last step is to measure your anchor. Make sure that it is at least 3.5 inches or 8 centimeters wide. Now press Done. Now press Use Anchor. Your image should now appear on top of the anchor whenever the anchor is in view. Do not hold the phone in your hand and try to draw. You can easily make a stand out of objects found around your house, like with tape and a tall glass, tape and a tall spray can. You can also purchase an inexpensive stand like this one. A link to stands that we recommend can be found in the app. If your camera is not in focus, press Tools, then Camera, and then Fix Focus. This will refocus the camera to your paper. Your image will appear in the center of your anchor. To position your image on your paper, use two fingers to zoom out so you can see your paper as a whole. Then press the Move button, and using one finger, you can pan your image. Using two fingers, you can enlarge, shrink, and rotate your image. When you're done, make sure to press the Move button again to lock the image in proportion so you can zoom in to draw fine details, or you can zoom out to see your drawing as a whole. Now you can adjust the opacity. Press the Opacity button at the bottom right corner of the screen to make the image more or less transparent. To apply image filters, go to Tools, then Filters, and then press the Filters button. Filters can make your image easier to draw by helping you see different elements more clearly. You can also use the Breakdown tool by going to Tools, then Breakdown, and then Setup. This lets you break down your image into layers by color value. This is great for turning any image into a paint-by-numbers tutorial, or if you're an advanced artist, it can help you analyze the no-tan or structure and composition of your artwork. To use the Strobe feature, go to Tools, then Strobe. This tool slowly flashes the overlay image on and off, allowing you to easily compare color values of your reference image to your drawing. This is one of the most powerful tools in the entire app. To get to the last absolutely need-to-know feature, press Tools, then slide all the way to the right and press Record. Then turn the Record switch on. This lets you record awesome time lapses of your artwork without the overlay, just like this one. Make sure if you post your time-lapse videos on social media to tag us at DaVinciEye for a repost. If you need help with anything, you can always press the help question mark in the top right corner of the screen. From there, you can check out our frequently asked questions, watch instructional videos, and even email us. We usually respond extremely fast to emails and love to hear from artists and aspiring artists using the app. Be sure to subscribe to us on YouTube and follow us on Instagram, TikTok, and Pinterest to see instructional videos and demos how to use all the awesome features DaVinciEye has built in.